Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Happy New Year. Make sure this year you work hard, hate less, respect more, and love your family as well as your country. Now, in this video, we are going to cover the current affairs for mobile optimized ebooks. You can install GK Today Academy app and you can get PDF there. So now, let's start. Which state is going to observe 2020 as Sushasan Sankalp Varsh? Right answer is Haryana. So Haryana is going to observe 2020 as Good Governance Year. Now, if we talk about good governance, 25th of December is celebrated as Good Governance Day. It is celebrated on the birth anniversary of former Prime Minister Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Now, this year on Good Governance Day, Government of India released Good Governance Index. And this index divided states and union territories into three categories. One is big states, another one is hill states and northeast states of India. Third one is union territories. So if we consider big states, then Tamil Nadu is the top performer. On the other hand, Goa, Uttar Pradesh and Jharkhand are the worst performers. If we talk about hill states and northeast states, then Himachal Pradesh is on top. And in case of union territories, Puducherry is on top while Lakshadweep is the worst performing union territory. Now answer in comment box, Lakshadweep union territory is under the jurisdiction of which high court? So Haryana is going to celebrate 2020 as good governance year. On the other hand, Telangana is going to celebrate 2020 as year of artificial intelligence. And recently it was in news that world's first graduate level artificial intelligence university will be started in UAE. The capital of UAE is Abu Dhabi and Dubai is the largest city of UAE. And recently in Dubai, world's first camel hospital was started. India's first elephant hospital was started in Uttar Pradesh. Which government is going to conduct night walk to promote women empowerment? Right answer is Kerala. So Kerala Women and Child Development Department is going to conduct night walk for women. And the objective of this initiative is to spread awareness about the increasing violence against women. And this event is going to be conducted between 11 a.m. to 1 a.m. at 100 locations in Kerala. Now, if we talk about Kerala, recently former Kerala Minister Mr. Thomas Chandy passed away. Kerala was also in news as Kerala will be setting up India's first IWTC, that is International Women's Trade Center. Kerala was also in news as recently Kerala High Court passed a judgment that access to internet is a fundamental right. Now answer in comment box, how many fundamental rights are mentioned in Constitution of India and how many of them are applicable only on Indians? That means how many fundamental rights are exclusively for Indians? Now coming back to Kerala, Kerala was also in news because of Silver Line project, as recently government approved Kerala semi high speed rail project and the name of this project is Silver Line project. So a question could be asked that Silver Line project is associated to which state or associated to which sector? In which state India's first university for transgender community will be opened? Right answer is Uttar Pradesh. So India's first university for transgender community will be established in Kushinagar district of Uttar Pradesh. The chief minister of Uttar Pradesh is Mr. Yogi Adityanath. And this University for Transgender Community will be set up by Akhil Bharatiya Kinnar Siksha Seva Trust. Now, if we talk about Uttar Pradesh, recently Uttar Pradesh was in news as it is going to be the host of this year's Defence Expo. That means Defence Expo in 2020. Apart from that, Uttar Pradesh was also in news as recently it launched a dedicated portal and mobile application named eGanna. Ganna stands for sugarcane. So this is for sugarcane farmers and this will provide information to farmers related to sugarcane. Apart from that, Uttar Pradesh was also in news as recently it launched campaign against filaria. In addition to that, Uttar Pradesh was also in news as recently it opened Itawa Lion Safari for general public. It is in Uttar Pradesh. Apart from that, recently NCRB released crime data. NCRB stands for National Crime Record Bureau. It is an organization under Ministry of Home Affairs. Present Home Minister is Mr. Amit Shah. Now coming back to NCRB report. As per NCRB report, Uttar Pradesh is on top in terms of violence against women, that means crimes against women. On the other hand, recently, CRY also released a report. CRY stands for Child Rights and You. And as per this report, Uttar Pradesh is also on top position in terms of crimes against children. Now, this CRY is a non-governmental organization. Apart from that, Uttar Pradesh was also in news as recently it was the host of All India Police Science Congress. And this Congress held in Lucknow. And for this Congress, Ms. Kiran Bedi was the chief guest. She is the first female IPS officer of India. IPS stands for Indian Police Service. Pakistan, one among the three countries in the world with polio endemic, is planning to import polio markers from India. Which are the two other countries? So answer is Afghanistan and Nigeria. Currently, there are only three countries in the world where polio is still endemic. These three countries are Pakistan, Nigeria and Afghanistan. Now, Pakistan and Afghanistan are the Asian countries, while Nigeria is African country. Actually, after the abrogation of Article 370, Pakistan had suspended the import of polio markers from India. Now, recently, Pakistan cabinet had decided to import polio markers, and that's why this question was in news. And that's why this topic was in news. Now, what is the use of these polio markers? Actually, these polio markers are used to mark the fingers of children after they were given polio vaccination. Now, if we talk about Pakistan, recently Pakistan was in news because it became the first country to introduce new vaccine to combat typhoid. Pakistan was also in news because of Kartarpur corridor. In addition to that, recently Pakistan was also in news as Pakistan had issued special permits to Emir of Qatar to hunt Hobara bustards. If we talk about Qatar, the capital of Qatar is Doha. Qatar is going to be the host of FIFA World Cup in 2022. And recently, in 2019, Qatar left OPEC. Headquarters of OPEC is in Vienna. In 2020, Ecuador has decided to leave OPEC. The headquarters of IAEA is also in Vienna. IAEA stands for International Atomic Energy Agency. Now coming back to Pakistan, Pakistan was also in news as it was the host of 7th Regional Forum of IUCN. IUCN stands for International Union for Conservation of Nature, and this forum held in Islamabad in Pakistan. Now IUCN was also in news as recently it updated its red list, and as per the updated list, 1840 new species were added into this red list. This red list consists of a catalogue of plants and animals that risk extinction, and this updated red list was released during COP25. This COP25 held in Madrid in Spain. Previously, it was supposed to be held in Chile. However, because of civil unrest in the country, Chile government decided not to host it, and therefore the venue was shifted to Madrid in Spain. Which organization gives forecast on general locust situation in global community? Right answer is FAO, that is Food and Agriculture Organization. Actually, recently Gujarat was in news because of this locust invasion. This is serious for the crops as this led to significant damage to crops. This locust is an invasive species, and this locust is locally known as Tiddi. Now coming back to FAO, FAO gives timely information on the general locust condition to the global community, and therefore it provides warning and forecast to those countries that are likely to be in danger of locust invasion. If we talk about FAO, it is Food and Agriculture Organization. The headquarters of FAO is in Rome in Italy. And recently, Italy was in news as it decided to impose web tax on digital companies from 2020. It is similar to GAFA tax by France. GAFA stands for Google, Apple, Facebook, Amazon. Now, Italy was also in news as it is going to be the host of 2026 Winter Olympic Games. China is going to be the host of 2022 Winter Olympic Games. On the other hand, if we talk about Summer Olympic Games, Japan is going to be the host of Summer Olympic Games in 2020, and France is going to be the host of Summer Olympic Games in 2024. Now, Italy was also in news as it is going to be the host of G20 Summit in 2021. This year, that means in 2020, G20 Summit will be hosted by Saudi Arabia. And recently, Saudi Arabia was in as it became the member of FATF, that is Financial Action Task Force. Saudi Arabia was also in news as for the first time, it became a member of World Heritage Committee of UNESCO. Which of the following is called the Falcon Capital of World? Right answer is Nagaland. So Nagaland is called as the Falcon Capital of World. Actually, The Amur falcons are the small migratory raptor that breeds in Siberia and China. They are raptors and they are migratory species. And during winter times, they migrate to India. And Doyang Valley in Nagaland is the place where these birds stop during migration in winter. And therefore, Nagaland is called as the falcon capital of the world. Now, if we talk about Nagaland, recently, Nagaland government extended the ILP to Dimapur. ILP stands for Inner Line Permit. If we talk about ILP, recently MHA extended ILP to Manipur. So, therefore, Manipur became the fourth state which is having ILP. As of now, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, Nagaland and Manipur have Inner Line Permit. And recently, this ILP was in news because of Citizenship Amendment Act. As the Home Minister had announced that this law of Citizenship Amendment Act will not be applicable in the areas of ILP as well as in the areas of 6th Schedule of Constitution. According to Article 244 of Indian Constitution, 6th Schedule provides for the administration of tribal areas in Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. Now, one important fact that you should keep in mind about CAA is that it talks about 3 countries, 6 religions and the cutoff date is 31st of December 2014. Which of the following is the only ape found in India? Right answer is Hulk Gibbon. So, the tailless Hulk Gibbon is the only ape found in India. And it is the native to Eastern Bangladesh, Northeast India and Southwest China. Now, it is categorized into 2 categories. One is Eastern Hulk Gibbon and another one is Western Hulk Gibbon. And both these species are listed under Wildlife Protection Act, Act of 1972. Which American firm is developing the Project Kuiper, which is to launch thousands of satellites into space? So, Amazon is working on this project and this will form a mega constellation of satellites that will provide low-cost space internet to public. And these satellites are to operate from LEO, that is Low Earth Orbit. If we talk about Amazon, the founder is Mr. Jeff Bezos. And recently, Amazon was also in news because of Project Zero. It was launched in India to prevent the sale of counterfeit goods. Amazon was also in news as recently, Amazon's Audible launched Audible Suno in India. This is an app for audio entertainment. Apart from that, Amazon was also in news as recently, Forbes released a list of real-time billionaires. And this list was topped by Mr. Jeff Bezos. Which university is to offer the novel Bhut Vidya course to tackle psychosomatic disorders? Right answer is BHU. So BHU is set to offer a new course Bhut Vidya or Ghost Studies to tackle the psychosomatic disorders. The course is to be taught by Ayurveda facility. Now, if we talk about BHU, it was founded by Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya. And recently, on 25th of December, his birth anniversary was celebrated. Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya was conferred Bharat Ratan posthumously. And he founded BHU, that is Banaras Hindu University, in Varanasi. And there is a train in his honor and the name of train is Mahamana Express. This train is between Delhi and Varanasi. If we talk about Varanasi, recently Destination Northeast Festival held in Varanasi. This Varanasi city is in Uttar Pradesh. Apart from that, Varanasi was also in news as recently KVIC launched first terracotta grinder in Varanasi. KVIC is Khadi and Village Industries Commission. Answer in comment box, it is under which ministry? Apart from that, Varanasi was also in news as India's fastest indigenous train, Train 18, which is also known as Vande Bharat Express, runs from Delhi to Varanasi. Which state has recently approved the Mahatma Jyotirao Phule Farmer Loan Waiver Scheme? Right answer is Maharashtra. So recently Maharashtra government approved Mahatma Jyotirao Phule Farmer Loan Waiver Scheme that allows waiver for crop arrears. The objective of this initiative is to make farmers debt-free and to provide relief to non-defaulting farmers. Now, if we talk about Maharashtra, the Chief Minister of Maharashtra is Mr. Uddhav Thackeray and Governor is Mr. Bhagat Singh Koshyari. Maharashtra was also in news as Maharashtra was tagged with Odisha under Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat Maharashtra was also in news as recently India Justice report was released, and as per this report, Maharashtra is on top position in terms of justice delivery, and this report is released by Tata Trust. Apart from that, Maharashtra was also in news as Maharashtra government decided to set up Swachh Bharat World University. In addition to that, Maharashtra was also in news because of AMBIS. AMBIS stands for Automated Multimodal Biometric Identification System, and Maharashtra became the first state of India to adopt AMBIS. The government recently invited applications for Nari Shakti Puraskar. Now the question is, after which eminent personality these awards are categorized? Right answer is Mata Jijabai. So Nari Shakti Puraskar is an award conferred by the president to the women under 6 institutional category on International Women's Day. Now these categories are Mata Jijabai, Lakshmi Bai, Kannagi, Ahilya Bai Holkar, Rani Gaidinlu and Rudramma Devi. So these awards are given on International Women's Day. Answer in comment box on which date International Women's Day is observed. Saudi Arabia and Kuwait decided to resolve the dispute over which oil region. Right answer is neutral zone. Actually, recently Saudi Arabia and Kuwait resolved their dispute over neutral zone, which lies along their border. So this is Kuwait, this is Saudi Arabia, and this is the neutral zone. This area is full of oil resources, and that's why this was a bone of contention between these two countries. So now, after a period of 5 years, they have commenced oil extraction operation in this region, and both countries will share equal rights. Now, if we talk about Saudi Arabia, recently Saudi Arabia was in news as it decided to end gender segregation in restaurants. Saudi Arabia was also in news as recently it allowed women to serve in armed forces. Apart from that, Saudi Arabia was also in news as recently it took over G20 presidency from Japan. In addition to that, Saudi Arabia was also in news as Saudi Arabia is going to host World Snooker Ranking event for first time. Apart from that, Saudi Arabia was also in news as it will host its first women's tournament. It is going to host Ladies European Tour, and this event is going to be organized in March 2020. Apart from that, Saudi Arabia and USA are among topmost polluters as per CCPI, that is Climate Change Performance Index. Recently, this index was released during COP25, and as per this index, USA and Saudi Arabia are the topmost polluters, and Sweden is the least polluter. Sweden is followed by Denmark. India is on 9th position. The government recently announced free internet services to all villages by March 2020. Now, which initiative will be used to achieve this objective? Right answer is BharatNet. So BharatNet will be used to provide free internet services to the all villages by March 2020. If we talk about BharatNet, it is a network infrastructure initiated in 2017, and this project seeks to provide affordable last mile internet connectivity to the 2.5 lakh village panchayats in our country. And Ministry of Communication is the nodal agency to implement this project, and the funding will be through USOF, that is Universal Service Obligation Fund. Actually, this USOF was formed by the Government of India to help funding projects in rural areas, and the money for this fund, that means money for USOF, comes from Universal Access Levy, and this money is charged from telecom operators. And therefore, this money is used for rural projects. ASI recently discovered Sanskrit inscriptions about Saptamatriksha in Andhra Pradesh. These were issued by which king? Right answer is Satwana King Vijaya. So recently, ASI discovered inscriptions in Andhra Pradesh which was issued by Satwana King Vijaya. It is written in Brahmi script, and it is oldest example of its kind in South India. Now, if we talk about ASI, it is Archaeological Survey of India, and it is under Ministry of Culture. And recently, ASI was in news as ASI installed Chinese signboards at 5 ASI protected sites. These are installed to help foreign tourists. And these 5 protected sites are सारनाथ, चोखंडी स्तूपा, खुशीनगर पिपरा हवा, श्रावस्ती. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच रिवर द क्रूज शिप सबरीना विक्टोरिया विल ऑपरेट इन विच रिवर. राइट आंसर इज रिवर यांगजे. सो सबरीना विक्टोरिया इज अ रिवर क्रूज शिप एंड इट विल बी ऑपरेशनल इन 2020 इन चाइनाज रिवर यांगजे. इट इज लार्जेस्ट रिवर क्रूज शिप एंड दैट्स वाई इट वॉज इन न्यूज. नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट रिवर यांगजे, इट इज लॉन्गेस्ट रिवर इन एशिया एंड इट इज थर्ड लॉन्गेस्ट इन वर्ल्ड. इन एडिशन टू दैट इट इज द लॉन्गेस्ट इन वर्ल्ड टू फ्लो एंटायरली विद इन वन कंट्री. What is the objective of Siv Bhojan program that was recently approved by Maharashtra Cabinet? Right answer is subsidized meal. So this is a initiative to provide subsidized meal. So as per this initiative, the meal is provided at subsidized rate of rupee 10 at designated centers in the state of Maharashtra. The upcoming Aditya L1 mission is to operate from which orbit? Right answer is Halo orbit. So this Aditya L1 mission is India's first solar mission and it will be launched by ISRO in 2020 and this will be operating from Halo orbit. It is a three-dimensional operate and it is to operate from Lagrange point 1, that is L1. Shaheed Udham Singh, whose 120th birth anniversary was observed recently, is most associated with which incident? Right answer is Jallianwala Bagh tragedy. Actually, recently on 26th of December, the birth anniversary of Shaheed Udham Singh was celebrated. He is a well-known freedom fighter from Punjab. He was associated to Gadar Party. And he is best known for avenging the Jallianwala Bagh massacre by assassinating Michael Dyer. So these were the important questions of today's quiz. Thank you. And that's all for the day.